Hello everybody, how are you today? Welcome back to Lecture Maker Level 2. Today we reach lesson number 13 and today we continue from what we ended on the lesson 12, and we will continue to study the verb of the third group, the verb that have the three letters ire at the end. But we have to study how to use this verb when the subject is noi, voi or loro. Noi, we, voi, you all, loro, they. I will take some example of verbs with ire. For example, in the lesson 12 we use the verb dormire, in the lesson 12 we use the verb partire and the verb mentire. Today we can use other verbs, but of the same group. For example, offrire. Offrire, that means to offer. For example, if I want to say, we offer you a dinner, we offer you our hospitality, we use the verb offrire. Or, for example, the verb soffrire, soffrire, so offrire to offer, if you put the S in before, soffrire, the meaning is to suffer. For example, you are sick, or you have some big problems, oh, today we suffer, today I suffer, you use this verb. Soffrire. Another verb that we can always of the same group, ire, for example, coprire, coprire, that means to cover. For example, now today the sun is very, very strong, so I cover my head. Oh, it's raining, so I cover my coat with the raining coat. So I will use the verb coprire. The last three letters, as you can see, are ire, so third group. In the lesson 12 we studied these verbs, the verbs in ire, when the subject are io, tu or lui, lei. Today the subject that we study is noi, we, noi, that means we, voi, that means you all, and they, that means, sorry, they is the English word. So, noi, voi, loro, loro, that means they. So let's see when the subject is noi, what we have to do when you use this verb in ire. The rule is always the same. When there is a subject, we have to remove the last three letters. So we remove the three letters ire. And when the subject is noi, after removing the last three letters, we add, this is the verb offrire, after removing the three letters, we add iamo, so we add four letters. Offriamo, we offer, noi soffriamo, we suffer, soffriamo, iamo, noi copriamo, we cover. When the subject is voi, after removing the last three letters, we have to add three letters that are this one. For the verb offrire, offrite, so the letters that you have to remember when you use the verb ire and the subject is voi, the three letters to add are ite. Voi offrite, you all offer, voi soffrite, you all suffer, soffrite, voi coprite, you all cover, you cover. cover something, you can cover your head, you can cover your body, you can cover this table, and you cover your car. So, noi add four letters, iamo. The subject voi add three letters, ite. When the subject is loro, after removing the three letters ie, loro offrono, so you have to add the three letters ono, loro offrono, they offer, or simply offrono, without saying loro, because when you say offrono, people understand the subject is loro, loro soffrono, they suffer, loro coprono, loro coprono, they cover. So, when the subject is loro, you have to add the three letters ono, ono, ono. As we did in lesson 12, now I will write here one verb of gruppare, one verb of gruppare, and one verb of gruppire. And let's see when the subject is noi, when the subject is voi, when the subject is loro, if there are similarities or they use the same letters. For example, I use for group are, I use the verb are. Amare is to love or to like. For group are. For group ere, for example, I can use the verb vedere. Vedere to see. To see. Group ere. And for group ire, for the last group, I can use, for example, the verb sentire, sentire, we already used in the lesson 12, sentire, to hear, to hear. So, let's see, when we use the subject voi, and we use a verb of the first group are, after removing the three letters are, we still add, chiamo. When you use a verb in ere, and subject is voi, we still add iamo, and when verb is group ire, and subject is voi, we still use iamo. So when subject is noi, we use verb are, we use verb ere, or we use verb in ire, the four letters of ere are always the same, iamo. When the subject is voi, when you use a verb in are, group are, when the subject is voi, after removing the three letters are, you have to add the three letters are. If you use a verb of the second group ere, after removing the three letters ere, the three letters that you have to add are this one, ede. If you use a verb of the third group ire, after removing the three letters ire, the three letters that you have to add are this one, ite. Amare, voi amate. Verb in ere, vedere, voi vedete. Verbo sentire, voi sentite. So, ate for group are, ete for group ere, and ite for group ire. So, when the subject is voi, the three letters ed are always different. It depends if the verb you use is group are, group ere, or group ire. Remember these letters. Ate for group are, ete for group ere, and ite for group ire. Let's see how when the subject is loro. Let's see which are the letters that I will use. When I use a verb in are, after removing the three letters are, I have to add the three letters hanno. So, loro amano. They love. For example, what do they? They love Kuala Lumpur. Amano, amano, or loro amano Kuala Lumpur. They love Malaysia. Amano la Malaysia. They love my mom. Amano mia mamma. They love my car. Amano la mia macchina. I know when you use a verb in are, and subject is loro. When you use a verb in ere, after removing the three letters ere, you have to add the three letters as well, but ono. Ano for group are, ono for group ere, and when you use a verb of group ire, ono as well. So the subject is loro, you have to remember these three letters. For group are, ano, but for group ere and for group ire, you have to add ono after, of course, you add ono after moving the three letters ire and ere. So, for example, loro vedono, they see, loro sentono, they hear. For example, I want to say, they see my mom today. Vedono mia mamma oggi, or loro vedono. It's up to you if you want to pronounce the subject loro. They hear classical music. Sentono la musica classica, or loro sentono la musica classica. Loro sa più if you want to say or not. Okay? So, for today we completed the all the verbs, because this is the last lesson, because we completed to study all the Italian regular verbs. We studied the group are, we studied the group ere, and we studied the group ire. There will be one more lesson, and it will be the last one, the lesson 14, where I want to give you a guideline. I want to show you which are the letters and which are the differences between different group of verbs, are and ire, when you use the different subject. Thank you very much. This is the end of lesson 13. There will be one more lesson 14, and it will be our last lesson of lesson Lab 2. Thank you very much for following lesson 13. I'll see you again on lesson 14. Have a nice day.